wind is calm, runway 28 right at intersection Echo for takeoff.
After visiting Miller Miller Falls, I push on north, having to cover another 350 kilometers to reach the northernmost point in this getaway, that being the outpost of Cooktown. On the way I stop in at Herberton where my father was born, and Atherton where my 90-year-old auntie lives. I was born in these parts also, and it always feels like I'm coming home each time I revisit the tablelands. Herberton has not really made much progress over the years, and it still has a lot of the old buildings that were around when my father was a boy here. After a further stop in Atherton to see my auntie, I continue northward, camping here and there along the way. At Lakeland, a town that only can boast a petrol station and hotel, I stop on the side of the road to get an aerial view of a large banana plantation that is located here. I camped the night at Lakeland along with around a dozen or more other RVs that were either heading to, or coming back from, Cooktown. The next morning it's back on the road for the final leg into Cooktown, stopping along the way at an historic old hotel named the Lion's Den. The road in is a typically narrow road found in these parts, carving its way through the dense tropical rainforests that cover this area. From the air you get to really appreciate the grandeur of the mountain ranges and the denseness of the tropical rainforests that thrive in the hot and humid climate in these parts. Supposedly the hotel was named after the tin mine of the same name that was operating here in the late 1800s. The hotel and its outbuildings have been carved out of the surrounding vegetation and is a very popular stopover for a look around and a cold beer, or three. Graffiti, what graffiti? The walls and ceilings of every space in this hotel bears testimony to bygone travelers who have stopped in here and left their mark. In 1970, my uncle carved out this wooden saw which has been hanging here for the past 50 odd years. You can still see both my uncle's and my cousin's signatures on the saw. This area is a magnet for serious off-road campers and four-wheel drive enthusiasts. However, some take it a bit too far and pay the price. It's interesting looking at the quirky items you find scattered throughout this pub, and this sign gives a hint of the toughness of the people who live around here. Totally agree. On leaving the Lion's Den, it's only a short drive to another famous attraction that resides here. Black Mountain, with its aboriginal name being Kalkarjak R, given to it by the traditional owners, the Kukuyalanji people. It is both imposing in size and foreboding in that it is the home for many snakes, including the giant pythons that can grow to more than 5 meters. It is made up from massive granite boulders. The mountain was formed some 260 million years ago when a mass of molten rock slowly solidified deep below the Earth's surface. A geological anomaly occurred in the granite, which led to fracturing. The top of the fractured granite was gradually exposed as softer land surface above were eroded away, leaving behind isolated rectangular blocks. The solid granite core of the mountain now lies beneath the huge layer of jumbled boulders. Patches on the otherwise bare mountainside are large fig trees. Beneath the outer boulders lies a maze of passages and chambers. In the inky dark, sheer drops, pockets of bad air or unexpected encounters with snakes or bats are enough to deter anyone from venturing onto, into and up the jumble of boulders. It has been dubbed the Bermuda Triangle of Far North Queensland due to stories dating back to the late 1800s of people, horses and whole mobs of cattle disappearing. Then it's back on the road again with just around 50 kilometers to travel before I reach Cooktown.